Welcome to a lesson on using inverse cosecant, inverse secant, and inverse cotangent to evaluate expressions. So on these problems, we want to determine the exact value without a calculator. I've done some preliminary work. Notice here at the bottom I have our reference triangles. These will be very helpful in determining these values. Next, I also listed the possible outputs for these inverse trig functions. So the angle that these return must be within these intervals. Okay, let's take a look at number one. We have arc secant 2. So the first thing I would recommend is writing this as a ratio of 2 over 1. So we're looking for an angle that has a secant function value of 2 over 1. Remember, the secant ratio is the hypotenuse over the adjacent side. So if we look at our reference triangles down here, we want to find an angle that has a secant ratio of 2 over 1. If you look at this 60 degree angle, the hypotenuse over adjacent side will be 2 over 1. Which tells us our reference angle will be 60 degrees. Next, the angle must be in either the first or the second quadrant, but since the ratio is positive, we know it must be in the first quadrant. So the angle we're looking for is this 60 degree angle in the first quadrant. This is equal to 60 degrees, or in radians, that would be pi over 3. Number 2 is much more challenging. We want to find the arc secant of negative 2 square root 3 over 3. And again, our angle must be in this interval. So we're looking for an angle that has a cosecant function value of this, and the angle must be in this interval. Using these reference triangles, it's very difficult to recognize this ratio. So what might be helpful is to think of this as arc sine instead of arc cosecant. The only time that would be a problem is where the angle theta would be 0. So let's think of this as arc sine of the reciprocal, so negative 3 over 2 square root 3. That may not seem like a lot of help, but if we take this ratio now and rationalize it, I think we might recognize it. So I'll multiply the top and bottom by square root 3. So our denominator is going to be 6, and this simplifies nicely to negative square root 3 over 2. So our angle theta is going to have a sine ratio of negative square root 3 over 2. Let's ignore the sine for a moment and see if we can find an angle that has a sine ratio of square root 3 over 2. And if we look at the 60 degree angle again, the opposite over hypotenuse side will give us a ratio of square root 3 over 2. That tells us our reference angle is 60 degrees. Next, since this cosecant function value is negative, we're actually looking at a 60 degree reference angle in the fourth quadrant. So let's go ahead and sketch that. Well, a 60 degree reference angle in the fourth quadrant in this interval would actually be negative 60 degrees, and that is the angle that we're looking for. So we have negative 60 degrees, which is equal to negative pi over 3 radians. And one more here, number 3, we have arc cotangent negative 1. So I'm going to change this to negative 1 over 1. We want an angle that has a cotangent function value of negative 1 over 1. Looking at our reference triangles, a 45 degree angle has a cotangent ratio of 1, adjacent over opposite. So that tells us our reference angle will be 45 degrees. But since the function value is negative, in this interval we're going to be in the second quadrant. So we sketch a 45 degree reference angle in the second quadrant. Would look like this, which tells us the actual angle we're looking for is 135 degrees, which would be 3 pi over 4 radians. Let's go ahead and check these on the graphing calculator. Now there is no arc secant key, so what we're going to do is use arc cosine and take the reciprocal of this 2. So second cosine, so instead of 2 now we'll use 1/2 since we're using arc cosine instead of arc secant. That verifies number 1. And then for number 2, again, there's no arc cosecant key, so we'll use arc sine, and then we'll use this ratio instead. Verifies number 2. And then let's try number 3. We're going to have an issue here, but let's go ahead and try it. There's no arc cotangent key, so we'll use arc tangent. Reciprocal of negative 1 is still negative 1. But what happens here is it returns negative 45 degrees, which is not in the interval for the range of our cotangent. Therefore, our answer is correct here. The calculator is not going to be able to verify this for us. We can see it was going to be a 45 degree reference angle, but this obviously is going to be in the fourth quadrant, and our angle must be in the first or second. So you do have to be careful when you're verifying these on the calculator. Okay, let's take a look at three more. Again, we want to determine the exact value without a calculator. Number one, cosecant of arctangent U. So there's a couple things going on here. First, remember that arc cotangent is going to return some angle theta that has a cotangent function value of U over 1. Once we find this angle, or at least model it, we're going to find the cosecant of that angle. Remember, the range for arc cotangent is between 0 and pi radians, so let's go ahead and model this angle in the first and second quadrant, since we don't know if U is positive or negative. Remember, cotangent is the ratio of the adjacent to opposite side, so if this is our angle theta, adjacent over opposite side would be U over 1, and the same for this reference angle here. Again, if U is positive, we'd be over here. If U is negative, we'd be over here. We just don't know for sure. Now, using the Pythagorean theorem, we can obtain the length of the hypotenuse. U squared plus A squared must equal H squared. That will give us a hypotenuse length of the square root of U squared plus 1. So here are the two possible reference triangles. Now we want to find the cosecant of that angle. Remember, the cosecant would be the ratio of the hypotenuse to opposite side. So notice in both triangles it's going to be the square root of U squared plus 1 for the hypotenuse and 1 for the opposite side. And that's it for number 1. Okay, on number 2 we want the cosine of inverse secant square root U squared plus 5 divided by U. Again, this will return an angle theta, and then we want to find the cosine of that angle. So let's go ahead and see if we can model this angle on the coordinate plane with our reference triangles. Remember that inverse secant returns an angle between 0 and pi radians, so we'll have another reference triangle in the first and second quadrant that has a secant ratio of square root U squared plus 5 over U. So the hypotenuse over the adjacent side. There's our hypotenuse, there's the adjacent side, and the same over here. We need to find the missing side of this right triangle. Let's go ahead and show it this time. We would have the hypotenuse squared must equal U squared plus, we'll call it Y squared. So this will undo the square root. When we subtract U squared from both sides, it'll simplify out. So Y equals the principal square root of 5. So let's go ahead and label our triangle. Now once we have those angles modeled, we want to find the cosine of that angle. Well, the cosine of the angle would be the ratio of the adjacent side over the hypotenuse side. So we have U divided by U squared plus 5. Now notice on this problem I found the missing side of the right triangle. I didn't actually have to do that because we didn't need the opposite side in this case, but sometimes you may need to do that. Let's go ahead and rationalize this. So we'd have U times the square root of the quantity U squared plus 5 all over U squared plus 5. Secant of arc cotangent of the square root of 4 minus U squared divided by U. So again, this is some angle theta, so that has a cotangent function value of square root of 4 minus U squared over U. Cotangent returns an angle again in the first and second quadrant. Let's go ahead and model this angle with two reference triangles, and the adjacent over opposite side would look like this in the first quadrant and similarly in the second quadrant. Again, we need to find the hypotenuse because in this case we are going to find the secant of that angle. So again, using the Pythagorean theorem, we have the hypotenuse squared must equal U squared plus the square root of 4 minus U squared squared, which should be 4 minus U squared. So we have H squared equals 4, H equals 2. So the secant of this angle would be the ratio of the hypotenuse over adjacent side. So 2 divided by the square root of 4 minus U squared. And let's rationalize again. So our rationalized answer would be 2 times the square root of 4 minus U squared all over 4 minus U squared. Remember, we cannot simplify this because it's attached to this by subtraction. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.